Hello everyone, welcome to all for the lecture series of Naval Architecture for MEO examination. If you are visiting my channel first time, please like, share and subscribe. Also, don't forget to press the bell icon to get the exciting lectures on Naval Architecture.
Hello everyone. This is the lecture number 11 of the lecture series of Naval Architecture made for the MEO examination. In this lecture series, we are going to discuss the numericals on the form coefficient. In the lecture number 10, we have discussed what is form coefficients, what are the different form coefficients are used in the ship design. We have discussed what is the significance of the form coefficients in a ship design. In today's lecture, we will have some numericals on the basis of a form coefficients. So this is the simplest numerical from this topic. So the numerical is like this: a ship length 135 meter long. So length of the ship is 135 meter long, 18 meter beam, means that the beam is given 18 meter and the draft is given 7.6 meter. Has the displacement of 14,000 tons. So generally we are denoting displacement with the delta, that is 14,000 tons. The area of the load water plane area is 1925 meter square, means water plane area is given. We are denoting with AW, that is 1925 meter square. And the area of immersed midship section is 130 meter square. We are denoting midship section with AM, that is 130 meter square. Now they are asking, calculate CW, means water plane area coefficient, CM is a midship coefficient, CB is a block coefficient and CP is a prismatic coefficient. So we will write the formulas here. Water plane area coefficient CW is equal to AW by L into B, L into B. Then what is AW? That is 1925 divided by L into B. L is given 135 and B is given 18 meter. Just the multiplication and divisions are there, you can get the value here. The second is you have a midship coefficient, that will be equal to CM is equal to AM by B into D. D is the draft. AM is given 130, B is given 18 and the draft is given 7.6. So if you do the calculation, you will get the value of this. Then the third is a C1, that is a CB, block coefficient. Block coefficient, now in this case they have given the displacement. So we have seen the block coefficient formula in terms of a displacement also. So I am going to write that formula. CB is equal to delta upon rho is the density of the liquid, L, B and D, that is a draft. So displacement is given 14,000 divided by density. Nothing is given that time, always you have to keep in your mind, you have to use the seawater density, that is 1.025 tons per meter cube. Then L will be 135, beam is 18 and the draft is 7.6. If you do this calculation, you will get the answer. The final thing is a CP, that is a prismatic coefficient. D1, CP is a prismatic coefficient. The same thing is applicable here also. Displacement divided by rho into AM into L. AM into L. So displacement is given to us, that is 14000. Density is 1.025. AM is given, that is 130. And length of the ship is given 135. So just the matter of calculation, you will get the answer. So this is the simplest numerical from the form coefficient, and this is the only, just you have to put the values given to you and you will get the answer. So like this you can solve the numericals on the form coefficient. We will see some of the numericals on the basis of this only, but way of asking is a little bit different, but the formula is the same, and the step only you will have only one or two steps only, but you have to understand the concepts that we will see now. Now coming to the second numerical from this topic. A ship is 150 meter long, so length of the ship is 150 meter, has a beam is 20 meter. Now something is given here, load draft is 8 meter. Now what is the meaning of load draft? So when the ship is completely loaded, that time the draft achieved by the ship is 8 meter. So I will use the word now D for the load, D load, draft for in a loaded condition, that will be 8 meter. And the light draft, what is the meaning of light draft? Light draft means ship's own weight is there, because of the ship's own weight, how much draft achieved by the ship. In other way, you can say that there is no cargo loaded in the ship. That time there will be some draft, so I will call as a D light. That is a 3 meter. So what is the meaning of that? If you add, initially the draft is a 3 meter, when you have added the cargo into the ship, automatically your ship is going to sink, and up to where it is sinking, from 3 meter to 8 meter. It means that 5 meter draft has increased because of the addition of the cargo only. The question will be like this only, how much extra cargo is required? Or you can say, what is the weight of the cargo? The weight of the cargo we are calling as a dead weight. Weight of the cargo is we are calling as a dead weight. Weight of a cargo means you have a, we can call as a dead weight. Weight of the ship alone, weight of a ship alone, we will call as a light weight. Now what is the total weight? Total weight is equal to dead weight plus light weight. Dead weight plus light weight. So the cargo weight we are calling as a dead weight, and weight of the ship alone we will call as a light weight. The total weight is equal to the dead weight plus light weight. So how to proceed for that? Now what they have given, the block coefficient at the load draft is given, and the block coefficient at the light draft is given. So how to proceed for this? What we are going to do now, we will find out the displaced volume. We will find out the So first of all we will do the calculation for the loaded condition. In a loaded condition we will do the calculation. So when the ship is completely loaded, how much displacement the ship is achieving? When the ship is completely loaded, how much will be the corresponding displacement, or you can say called as a volume of displacement. We will calculate the volume of displacement when ship is completely loaded. So what is the formula for that? The CB for the loaded condition, CB for the loaded condition it will be equal to, you can write the CB in terms of a displacement also, means in terms of a tons, you can write like this. So delta in a loaded means it will be in a tons, this value will come in a tons. So if you are writing this in a tons, denominator should be also in a tons. So rho into LB into D, which you have to take, that you have to take in a loaded condition, or you can say the loaded load draft. Okay, so you can calculate now displacement in a loaded condition divided by, now rho, now nothing is given regarding the density, so by default you can take a seawater density, that is 1.025 tons per meter cube. Length is given 150, beam is given 20, and the D loaded is given 8 meter. Then, and the CB in a loaded condition is given a 0.766. So you will get from here delta in a loaded condition, you will get 18384 into, that will be 1.025. If you do this, you will get the answer in a tons. You will get the answer in a tons. So you will get a displacement in a tons when the ship is completely loaded. Okay. Now, we will do the calculation for the light weight condition. Light weight condition means there is no cargo. There is no cargo. That time we are going to do the calculation. Same thing we are going to use. CB in light is equal to delta in light divided by rho into L into B into D light. So this draft you have to take in a light condition. So what is the CB light? That is equal to 0.668 into displacement in a light weight condition, means when there is no cargo, that time the displacement of the ship is 1.025, length is 150, beam will be same, only the D light is going to change, that is given 3 meter. So from here you can find out the displacement, that is in a tons of in the light weight condition. The answer will come, I have not multiplied 1.025, you can just multiply, you will get the displacement in the light weight condition, that is also in a tons. Okay, like this you will get. Now you have a displacement when ship is completely loaded, and you have a displacement when the ship is a unload condition, means when there is no cargo, because of its own weight the ship's displacement is this much. Now what they are asking, find out the dead weight, how much extra dead weight we have to add, so that you will achieve the displacement this much. Okay, so initially you have a this much displacement, when you have added the cargo, the displacement has increased to this much. So how to calculate that? Only you have to take the, do the subtraction of these two, delta loaded condition minus delta light condition, that is equal to the cargo weight, that is equal to the cargo weight, also called as a dead weight. What is the meaning of this? Try to understand this. Initially the displacement is 6192 into 1.025. It was the displacement when there is no cargo. When we have added the cargo, automatically the draft is increasing, and because of the increment in the draft, the displacement is also going to change. So increment in the displacement is equal to the how much cargo we have added. Okay, increment in the displacement is equal to the the cargo which is added into the ship. So how to proceed for that? So cargo added, or you can say the dead weight is equal to, dead weight is equal to delta loaded minus delta light. So you will get the that value is coming 12496.8 tons. So this much extra cargo we need to add in the lightweight ship so that we can achieve the delta loaded. In this way we can utilize this simple formulas to calculate the cargo load, or you can call as a dead weight. So we will see one more numerical to familiar with this all the formulas. So you will come to know that how to utilize these formulas and where is the application of these formulas. Now coming to the third numerical of this topic. In this numerical you can see a ship length is a 120 meter. Length of the ship is given 120 meter. The beam of the ship is given a 15 meter. Has a block coefficient, as a block coefficient CB is a 0.7, and is a floating in the load draft of 7 meter in fresh water. So draft is given 7 meter in a fresh water, in a fresh water. So fresh water means they are directly saying the density is a 1 ton per meter cube. Now find how much more cargo can be loaded if the ship is to float at the same draft in a salt water. So what is the meaning of this? Consider that initially, now apart from this numerical I will give some example so you can easily understand. Now this is the application of the buoyant force which I am going to discuss now. Now consider that my ship is there initially in fresh water. Initially my ship is there in fresh water where the density is 1 ton per meter cube. Now what is the formula for the buoyant force? Buoyant force is equal to rho V into G, and V is the underwater volume, G is the density. Okay, so please keep in your mind this formula. Now initially when the ship is there in a fresh water, the draft of the ship, they are saying it is a 7 meter. It is a 7 meter. Now my ship is traveling from the fresh water to the sea water. When the ship is traveling from this fresh water to sea water, now it is in a sea water, the density of the sea water is 1.025 tons per meter cube. And this density is always, the seawater density is always more than the fresh water. So what is the formula for the buoyant force? Rho V into G. So you can see here as the, what is the effect of, what is the effect of the change in density on the buoyant force? If you see here, buoyant force is directly proportional to the density of this, of the liquid where the ship is floating. It means that as the buoyant force increases, as the density increases, the buoyant force also increase. Buoyant force also increase. It means that if the buoyant force increases, if the buoyant force increases, what will happen? Now I am putting one condition. What is that condition? Please keep in your mind. Now I am talking apart from this numerical. Think that total weight of the ship is remains constant. For example, initially consider the total weight is 5000 tons. When the ship is moving from the fresh water to sea water, the total weight is remains constant. Like that I am assuming now. So when it is moving from the fresh water to sea water, what will happen? The buoyant force increases. Buoyant force increases. Okay, all of you please listen carefully here. This is the buoyant force. Any objects wants to float, that object has to satisfy buoyant force is equal to total weight. This condition, the ship should be in equilibrium condition. When the ship was there in a fresh water, that time the total weight is a 5000, the buoyant force was also 5000. Then only the ship was going to float, equilibrium condition will achieve at a 7 meter draft. Now what I am saying, when the ship is moving from the fresh water to sea water, what I am saying, total weight was remains constant. If the total weight is remains constant, then what will happen with the buoyant force? Buoyant force also should be constant only. Buoyant force should be, buoyant force also should be constant. Then only the ship is going to come in a equilibrium. But what I am saying now here, as you are moving from the fresh water to sea water, what will happen? The density is increasing. As the density increases, buoyant force also increases. But what I want, I don't want to increase the buoyant force. I don't want to increase the buoyant force. It means that if you see this formula of the buoyant force, there are only two variables, the density and the volume of displacement. These are the two variables. So if I want to keep the buoyant force is a constant and I am saying the density is increasing, it means that volume of displacement has to reduce. Volume of displacement has to reduce so that the buoyant force will remain constant. That is a 5000 tons. So it means that if the volume of displacement is reducing, it means that how it is going to reduce? The ship's draft has to reduce. Ship's draft has to reduce. Then only we can say the volume of displacement will reduce. As the volume of displacement is reduced, the buoyant force will be remains constant, because to compensate that, this density is increasing. As the density increases, volume of the displacement should be reduced, and volume of displacement should be is reducing by reducing the draft. It means that the final conclusion from here, that when the ship is moving from the fresh water to the sea water, the draft of the ship will be reducing. If you suppose numerical value, if I take initially if it is a 7 meter, when it is moving from the fresh water to sea water, the draft has to reduce from 7 meter to less than 7 meter. It has to reduce when it is moving from the fresh water to sea water, provided weight of the ship is going to remains constant when it is moving from the fresh water to sea water. Okay, now this numerical is little bit different, but the application will be remain same, which I have discussed just now. So you can see here what they are asking. Find how much cargo can be loaded if the ship is to float at the same draft in the salt water. It means that what they are doing now, they are not keeping the displacement constant. What they are doing, they are not keeping the total weight constant. They are asking now, what we have understood now, when the ship is moving from the fresh water to sea water, draft has to reduce. Draft has to reduce less than 7 meter. But what they are asking now, if I want to keep the draft constant 7 meter, how much extra cargo I have to add? How much extra cargo I have to add so that the draft of the ship in fresh water and in sea water will remain constant? Try to understand this, what I am saying now. They are asking now, we know that when the ship is moving from the fresh water to sea water, obviously the draft of the ship is going to reduce. But now what they are doing, they don't want to reduce the draft, they want to keep the draft as it is. 7 meter was there, now also they want to keep the 7 meter. But according to the rule, what will happen, according to the physics, what is going to happen, the draft of the ship is going to reduce when it is entering in the sea water. So if you want to keep the draft same, what we have to do, we have to add some extra cargo. We have to add some extra cargo, so then only the draft will be remains constant. Okay, so how to proceed for that? It means that the what we are going to do now, we are going to use the formula for the block coefficient. We will do that, all the things step by step. So what I will do now, I will calculate the block coefficient. I will calculate the displacement of the ship. When the ship is in their fresh water. So formula will be CB into displacement I am using. I will call displacement in fresh water divided by rho. This will be fresh water density into L into B into D draft. Okay. Like this I will do now. I will calculate the displacement of the ship in fresh water. The block coefficient is given 0.7. Fresh water density, that will be 1 tons per meter cube. L is given 120, B is given 15, and the draft is given 7 meter. If you do this, you will get an answer. The displacement of the ship in the fresh water, that is coming 8820 tons. So when the ship is there in a fresh water, that time the displacement the total weight of the ship is 8820 tons. Okay. Now what they are saying, you have to keep the draft constant. It means that the block coefficient will be remain same. It means that L, B, D, everything will be same. The only the density of the water is going to change. So for that purpose, I will do now CB is equal to delta in a sea water divided by rho in sea water L B into D. If you solve this one, you will get the delta in sea water will be 9040.5 tons. It means that to keep the same draft in the sea water, you have to put extra load. Now when the ship is there in the sea water, the displacement of the ship for the same draft is coming 9040.5. This much displacement is coming. It means that how much extra cargo you need to add when the ship is moving from the fresh water to sea water, you have to take the how to do the subtraction of a delta of sea water minus delta of fresh water, that is equal to the extra load. It will be 9040.5 minus 8820. That is equal to 220.5 tons that you can add extra when the ship is moving from the fresh water to the sea water to keep to maintain the same draft. I hope everything is clear to all of you. Now this is the fourth numerical of the same chapter, of the same topic. This is the same numerical as we have seen earlier, but only little bit changes are there. A ship is 100 meter long, beam is 15 meter, and the depth is given here is 12 meter, is floating on the even keel at the draft 6 meter. So L is given 100, beam is given 15, and draft is given 6 meter. The block coefficient is given 0.8. The ship is floating in a salt water. Initially, now ship is there in a salt water. Find the cargo to be discharged so that the ship will float at the same draft in a fresh water. Now, in earlier numerical, what we have seen, initially the ship was there in the fresh water. When it is moving from the fresh water to sea water, obviously draft was reducing. But now, this is just opposite. Initially the ship is there in the sea water. And when it is moving from the sea water to fresh water, obviously the draft of the ship is going to increase. Draft of the ship is going to increase, provided weight of the ship is remains constant. But what they are saying now, the ship is there initially, when the ship is there initially in the sea water, it is moving from the sea water to the fresh water, and in sea water the draft is around 6 meter. If you keep the total weight is remains constant, if you keep the total weight is remains constant, what will happen when the ship is moving from the sea water to fresh water, the draft of the ship has to increase, and that will be more than 6 meter. The draft of the ship is more than 6 meter. When the draft of the ship is to increase more than 6 meter, provided the total weight of the ship will be remains constant, if this is the condition. But what they are saying, they want to keep the same draft which was there in the sea water, same draft they want to keep in the fresh water, means they want to keep the draft 6 meter as it is. But as per the rule, what will happen if the ship is going in the fresh water, providing the total weight is remains constant, what will happen? The draft is increasing. But I want to keep the draft is remains constant. It means that I have to remove some amount of the weight, then only this condition will satisfy 6 meter draft in the sea water and the 6 meter draft in the fresh water. Otherwise, there is no chance of maintaining the same draft. So how much cargo you have to remove? Same thing we have to do. We have to do the calculation, find out the, you are keeping the draft constant, it means that the CB will be remains constant. Only you have to find out the displacement when in a sea water, that will be rho of the sea water L B D. Same thing, CB delta in a fresh water divided by rho into L into B into D. Find out the delta in a sea water, find out the delta in a fresh water. Delta you have to take, this is 1.025, and this one you have to take 1. So final answer you will get, that will be in a sea water, but displacement will come 7380, and when the ship is moving in the fresh water, that time the displacement will be 7200 tons. So how much extra cargo you have to remove if you want to maintain the same draft? You can use the word here, cargo remove, cargo discharge. You can use the word cargo discharge is equal to delta sea water minus delta fresh water. The answer will come 180 tons of the cargo you have to discharge, then only you can maintain the draft of 6 meter in a fresh water as that of a sea water. I hope all of you understood this whole chapter of the form coefficients. In whole chapter we have discussed about what is mean by form coefficient and what is the significance of this form coefficient in a ship design. In today's lecture we have discussed the numericals on the basis of a form coefficients. Okay, thank you very much. We will meet in the next lecture.